Let's send it out to Dean. He's outside. Good morning, Dean.
Hey, you guys. Yeah, welcome back. Our 17th annual drive-through toy drive starting off strong this morning. We want to thank the International Gem and Jewelry Show for their very generous donation this morning. Before we get to our weekend Dean's List, you met Joaquin a couple of minutes ago donating toys, but you didn't see Joaquin's incredible dance moves that he's got. You ready, Joaquin? Give it to us. Yeah, all right. Take a look at the weekend Dean's List. Take a look.
Would you look at me? I haven't looked like this since.
Never. You look like this never.
For the holidays, the all-ages family film to see will be the sequel to 2017's Jumanji Welcome to the Jungle. In Jumanji, the next level, all of the major players are back with the addition of Danny Glover, Danny DeVito, and Awkwafina, all getting zapped back into that wild virtual world to rescue one of the players. This time when they go back, they become each other, offering up impersonation palooza. Think The Rock channeling Danny DeVito or Kevin Hart channeling Danny Glover. Some good laughs at first, even though they do beat it into the ground. Aside from that, it's the usual effects fest of dangerous beasts and nonstop wisecracks. Not exactly high art, but sometimes that's just what you want in a movie. I give it a Dean's List B-. Also new this week is the latest American tale told by a four-time Oscar winner Clint Eastwood. In Richard Jewell, he directs an excellent ensemble of Sam Rockwell, Kathy Bates, John Hamm, and relative newcomer Paul Michael Hauser as Jewell himself in the 1996 story of the Atlanta Olympic bombing, in which an overzealous security guard discovers a backpack that ultimately blew up, killing two and injuring more than 100 others. At first, Jewell was labeled a hero, but hearsay gossip and rumors about him turned him into the FBI's number one suspect, something that was leaked to the news media who ran with the story, destroying Jewell and his mother's life before the case was ultimately dropped. Before you see Richard Jewell, understand that it's not a documentary. Eastwood bases the plot on events that happened in his typical straightforward style. But besides playing fast and easy with the facts, political rhetoric that the media is bad and that you can't trust the FBI overshadows this Dean's List B-.
Yay! Hello, Bedford Falls!
Also, the Music Box Theater holds its annual Christmas sing-along double feature on the big screen with It's a Wonderful Life and White Christmas now through Christmas Eve.
Ah, humbug!
On stage, the Goodman Theater's timeless A Christmas Carol continues through December 29th. And the Shakespeare Theater's hip-hop spin on the Dickens classic returns. See Cube Brothers' Christmas Carol, now through the 23rd. Around town, the Lincoln Park Zoo's zoo lights shine every day through January 5th. And Brookfield Zoo flips the switch on its holiday magic through December 31st. Tonight in music, it's 21 Pilots at the Aragon. Smooth jazz man Dave Koz brings his Christmas show to the Chicago Theater. Tomorrow, catch Mumford & Sons at the Aragon. A cappella superstar Straight No Chaser come to the Chicago Theater. 90s rockers Sister Hazel play the House of Blues tomorrow and Sunday. And Chicago's very own Jane Lynch brings her irreverent swinging little Christmas show with The Office's Kate Flannery and Glee's Tim Davis today and tomorrow at the Rouse Center in Crystal Lake, and then for two shows at the City Winery on Sunday. And as always, you can get my full reviews, more information, all up at WGNTV.com/Dean's List. Once again, this year, we want to thank the members of the Maine East High School Rotary Interact Club who raised money for us. Give me your names.
My name is Rob Payne. I'm the CT teacher.
I'm Azhar Maradi, a co-president.
I'm Tamara Patel, a co-president.
And I'm Risha Parikh, another co-president.
Very nice. Well, we want to thank you guys for coming out bright and early this morning. Explain what you did and, you know, what your return was for us this year.
Okay. So we're Rotary Interact at Maine East High School. And this year, alongside our 200 members, student members, we've raised over $3,000 to donate toys to this toy drive.
And was it, like, fellow students helping out?
Yeah, it was our student members. It was Target that helped us out, our CTE department in Maine East, and also Park Ridge Rotary, the Park Ridge Club.
Yeah, this is a thing that you guys have done for us every year, and we really appreciate it. I got to think that everybody's like super generous and wanting to help out the kids especially this time of year, right?
Yeah, for sure. This is an event that all of our members jump to help at, especially purchasing the toys at Target.
Yeah, pretty proud teacher, I would think, huh?
Yeah, proud of all of our students doing the work that they do, helping out with this this activity, the digital literacy we do for elderly in the area, as well as the Haiti outreach we do. Yeah, a lot of really good stuff that these students do.
Well, we really appreciate all of you. Thank you, and everyone at Maine East. We appreciate your donation. Our drive-through toy drive this morning is going to continue all the way through till 10 o'clock this morning. Stick around. We'll have much more coming up. Come on out and see us, 2501 West Bradley Place, all morning long. Thanks.